You're listening to KEVL Rock Radio. On this episode of the True Metal Radio Show, we'll hear Exhorter, Warbringer, Pestilence, Hate Eternal, and more. Plus, we'll have a look at the big book of True Metal, but first, a toast to the 35th anniversary of Slayer's Reign in Blood. 35 years, album. Man. How old do I have to feel for that to...
Well, I was 4 when it came out, so...
Oh, yeah, of course.
Well, that's basically a generation. A generation of music.
It is a generation of music.
That album can actually have raised children, and those children had children of their own.
It's almost by today's standards, that's a grandparent level age.
Well, I can tell you exactly where I was when I bought it.
You were 4.
I was 4.
It's their third studio album. They were already on Metal Blade, but Dave Lombardo, for whatever reason, I guess he heard that Rick Rubin might be interested in them, and he became very interested in pursuing them. So Rick Rubin got very passionate about Slayer, and Dave was able to convince everyone else to have a look at this hip-hop label.
Well, he had no choice. I mean, with Def Jam, they needed to, because if they didn't, they were pretty much ostracized. They were one of the bands that got the shit axe.
Yeah.
It was really shitty what happened to those guys back then.
And Rick wasn't like a huge deal quite yet, you know.
He wasn't big in our realm of music.
Not in our world.
He never did anything. But dude, Def Jam Records, I mean, what do you think?
Yeah.
I mean, they were getting somewhere. Not with the long hairs, but you know.
This album was also their first Billboard 200 entry at number 94. 1986, that's a big deal, I think.
It's big. I mean, you already had, 84 and 85 was a big year for metal, so it kind of laid the groundwork for them.
Yeah.
But think about their previous albums. You had Show No Mercy and Haunting the Chapel. I mean, that's not cracking any Billboard in America in the 80s. Sweet Jesus.
Yeah, Hell Awaits.
Yeah. These are nice little ditties.
Rolling Stone called this album number 6 greatest metal album of all time.
I could see that's in my top 5.
Yeah, it's in my top 5 too. Now, this album was delayed because of Angel of Death. Apparently, there was some concern because Angel of Death, the content, is about Auschwitz. It's about Dr. Menengele.
You call him Klaus Barbie, huh? Is that?
Yeah. So, they had to convince the powers that be that, look, celebrating it. We are talking about how horrifying it is. So...
It's just great seeing the passion that you guys have for this. It's very entertaining.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate that.
I'm asleep at this point in time.
For those of you who don't know, that voice you're hearing is the station manager, Percy.
Percival.
Percival Dickey, who has decided to join us today. And we'll talk about that later on.
Yes.
We have a whole segment dedicated to talking about that. Lombardo quit in 86 while they were on tour. Apparently, he had bills to pay, and they weren't getting paid. And this is a big tour, and they're just in classic fashion for, you know, not being taken care of, musicians not being taken care of. It's the way of the music industry and the radio industry. Isn't that right?
Yes. But wait, hang on now. Hang on. I like to think that we of us, we are a family, all of us here.
Sure.
All together, pulling together. I would like to say one thing. None of you got the memo about Astro Spirit Day?
Dude, I took my shirt off before I got in here because I was afraid I was going to get shit canned for having to wear Astro stuff.
It's Astro
Spirit
Day.
This guy hates it, but he hates it when I wear anything sports. I mean, he hates it.
That's why it was in the memo.
He gets as mad as his fucking GoPro.
It was in the memo. All right? It was a nice thank you to the station owner. Call back to his Hall of Fame pitching days.
So a toast. A toast to Slayer.
And the Astros kicking ass 2 days in a row.
All right.
There you go.
All right.
And that's why we're waiting on Numbnuts.
Yeah, is he at a game?
Well, he's in his car. He said he's here. Now, that was 10 minutes ago. I don't think he's found his way up here yet.
That's quite unprofessional of him.
I didn't want to say anything like that, but... Mr. Percival, please. Please, give him some shit.
well,
I already know you'll probably fire him anyway, so.
He's definitely riding a rail of suspension, I'll tell you that.
I gotcha. This is good. It's not,
we're weaponizing
not so good.
Percival.
All right.
No,
I like
no,
that.
No, I'm going to hear both sides.
Uh-huh.
And then I'm going to take action.
Oh, my. You know what? I'm liking this already. I really am.
Yeah.
I think it's really nice.
Well, thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
I like that. I like someone that likes to drop the...
Would you do me a kindness and hand me a shot off of that,
absolutely,
off of that bar? Thank you, sir.
Did you want to drink that off me, Dave? Is that what you're going to say?
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Would you like
First
me to lean
all,
over?
Would you like a shot, sir?
Oh, thank you. No, I've got to check the Wichita overnights.
All right. He's going to check the Wichita overnights.
Hey.
Yeah.
If Kevin's actually really here, do
He's
we want to...
He's not here. I just looked at the camera. He's not here.
He's somewhere else. I think Kevin said, I'm here, and he doesn't know where here is. That was about 4 minutes ago.
Okay, he's pulling in right now.
Oh, he's here. He was in the parking lot here. Then that's
I mean, I can see the security camera, and he's coming through the gate right now.
Hey,
in the lot.
Can you tell me if Tommy's parked out there by any chance?
I cannot tell.
He said he parked in the third lane. Remember, he... Oh, I see Kevin pulling in.
Yeah.
Either that's Kevin or Tommy.
No, that's Kevin.
So, Percival.
Yes, sir?
We had this actual fan of ours.
He's running.
That we were so blessed to read one of these god-awful letters that you folks make us read. He's a stalker. This guy, I mean, God love him. I mean... Right? I mean,
yeah, there's a guy named Tommy that wrote in the suggestion box segment, and instead of writing a suggestion, he just wrote us basically a love letter that was terrifying. It was a very long, and Tommy, if you're listening, we love you. It was very good.
Yeah,
we appreciate it.
Look, guys, I'm sure that's perfectly fine, but the thing about this is...
Is that door open for him? Is the studio door open for him?
I didn't close it, so...
Okay. You might have trouble getting it. Let me make sure.
I don't know if he's going to have trouble walking. I don't know... I don't think his Audi says Audi anymore.
Glad you could join us.
Thank you.
Oh, are you in shit city?
What's he doing here?
He absolutely got the memo. He's wearing his Astro Spirit gear.
Oh, he did get the memo.
That's because he just came from the game, asshole.
All right. Why is he here, though? Am I in trouble?
Cheers to Slayer's 35th anniversary.
Here, you got here just
blood.
In time.
Oh,
there you go, buddy. You thought you were getting out of this ceremonial. That's it.
Salute.
Salute.
It back. It ain't
Salute.
No candy.
Ain't candy. Right.
Smile was black to his green.
Longer to slay a fucking lick. There's a cold 12
it just
in a bottle.
Get
of
oh my god, what is that? Is that seven?
That wasn't our
no,
typical.
No, it's Jameson.
Oh, really?
That
I wasn't expecting that.
Drink.
I happen to be drinking Jameson 18, and it does not blend well with the regular Jameson, I think.
What is Percy doing here?
Kevin, that's Percival. We've had this conversation before.
We're gonna talk about this in just a moment.
Remember, every time we hear that name, we're gonna have to hit the button. Tell Numbnuts back there. You got to remind him. He's asleep at the wheel. We gotta talk about Ryan.
Ryan is very good. I think Ryan is excellent.
He's got a.
He's my favorite Percy. Absolutely.
All right. Well, I think this has gone terribly, and we're gonna move on now. So, how about some music? You guys want to hear something, or
you got
should
some
we just
polka?
Sit here?
What we got?
We got a little bit of polka for you.
All right.
This Sounds is a little good. Polka song I like to call "Epidemic."
All right.
You keep the